Hey guys, thanks for stopping by my channel. It's Meaty. Today I wanted to talk to you guys about starting over, a topic that I am a professional because I started over in so many areas of my life. So there's a few different segments that I'm going to have. So this one's going to be starting over your career when you're talking about careers. The next one will be on divorce, and the other one will be with your finances, because obviously if you've had these changes, you know, your finances, you have to start over anyways. So starting over in your career. So I have 5 bullet points as far as what you need to do when you have to start over with your career. Or, you know, and I didn't do it exactly in this way, and I'm just listing these because I think that they're a good piece of advice for somebody who needs to start over. Some of them I didn't particularly do myself, but I wish I would have. And that's the first one, which is take a minute. Take some time to take this whole thing in and envision what it is that you want to do. You know, if you have to mourn the loss of your career and that you have to change businesses and reinvent yourself, take the time to do that. You know, I'm not saying take a year off, because not everybody has the luxury to do that, but I do think that you need some time to understand what's happening and really, you know, take it in and assess what you want to do and where you want to go from here. Okay, that would be my first thing. The next thing is, once you decided what it is that you want to do, so if you want to change from being, say, a sales rep, and now you want to get into, I don't know, real estate, for example. So I would sit down and take a pen and paper and write down a plan. What it is that you have to do? Do you have to get licensed? Do you have to get any permits or anything that you might need to do to be able to do this type of business? Research what type of marketing you'd have to do, what kind of budgets you might have to set up for yourself, that type of thing. Because you have to really set yourself up and make sure that this is something that you're going to be able to, you know, accomplish. And how long is it going to take you, right? Another thing I would say, and I say this because this is a good time if you maybe, say, for example, are in sales and you've been doing sales, but then you have this kiteboarding thing that you're doing and you teach on the weekends, you teach kids on the weekends how to kiteboard, and it's been okay, and you've always wanted to do that maybe full time, but you didn't think that that's something that you can do. Well, now might be that time. So if that's something that you really like, you have a side hustle and you kind of want to make that as your priority, and that's going to be your main source of income, well, then you need to get a game plan together to make sure that you can do that and that you can sustain yourself and your family if you have one with that income. So I would say assess that and make a plan for that, because, you know, no plan, no place. Like, how are you going to get it done? The other thing I would say is take a reality check, okay? So I say this because there's so many people out there, so many voices out there saying, you know, do what you love and you'll never work a day in your life. That's what you should do, your passion. And I get it. And I totally agree. I agree in some way that, yeah, that would be awesome. And a lot of people are able to make money with their passion. But it really depends what your passion is. You know, doesn't that make sense? Like, I don't know. I mean, and again, your passion, that you might have this passion that you really love doing one thing, and that might not necessarily be something that is going to pay the bills. I don't know. Maybe that's me being negative, but I don't know. I just, to me, just a realistic is a realistic point of view is what I'm saying. Make sure that you can make, you know, money and sustain yourself with this passion that you say you have. So, and I say this from experience, because I absolutely love furniture and interior design and all this. I'm not licensed as an interior designer or any of that. I went off and I bought a furniture consignment business because I loved furniture and I loved decorating my house. Well, the furniture business sales is completely different than what I love decorating my house. And I learned that quickly after I was in it. So, you know, I was kind of thinking like, oh, I love furniture, I love design, I love all this stuff, I can't wait to do this. And then once I was in it, the last thing I was doing was designing anything or decorating anything. I didn't like it, because I had to deal with these people who were kind of petty, and I just didn't like it. You know, I was, you know, sales, what, like, you know, selling a chair or something, I didn't want to do that. So yeah, think about it before you actually put, you know, money and effort into it, that it's something that's going to pay your bills and that you're going to be able to prosper, and is it something you really want to do? And then lastly, what I would say is take action. You know, because we can sit here all day long and talk about, you know, what I want to do and I'm really dreaming of doing this and I'd really love to do this, but if you don't do anything and all you're doing is talking about it, it's never going to happen, right? So even like this, what I'm doing right now, I've been thinking about it, and I finally did it. I mean, I don't even have an awesome camera. This is an iPhone I'm using in my office, and I'm talking to you guys from here. And the quality, I've seen some videos out there, the quality is amazing. It's like if they have their own videographers and all this, you know, hoopla, which I don't have. Not yet, but you know, who knows? Maybe one day I will, or I won't. But this is what I'm doing, and I'm trying it out. And it might do well, and it might not. But at least I'm taking action, and I'm doing something about it. So that's what I'm saying is, if you're gonna do something, if you wanna do that side hustle, do it, but do it, and advertise it. Put it on Facebook, on your social media, make a website. I'm making my website cost me $170, and I designed the site myself, I did everything myself. You can do it. You just have to take the time and take the initiative. So I would say those five things are good tips and points. There could always be more, but for the time that this video was here, I just wanted to present this to you guys and see if you like it. And I hope you do, and that you'll make a comment and like my channel, and that you'll keep seeing my videos. Bye.